There are some settings so important. We really need to know how they work and how to use them. What's up guys, Dan Frullani here and welcome back to another video. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing and since you're there, hit the like button. Well, today I would like to talk about something very important that we all need to know before pressing the rec button, and I'm talking about camera basics for video. There are some settings so important to be able to get acceptable footage that we really need to know how they work and how to use them. In this video, I'm gonna cover three of them, which I consider the most important ones: shutter speed, aperture, and ISO. They have one thing in common. They all directly control the brightness of the footage, but it's not just about the brightness of the footage. So I start talking about shutter speed. What's a shutter speed? Is the amount of time measured in fractions of a second that the shutter stays open, allowing the light to hit the sensor. Therefore, with a fast shutter speed, there would be a darker footage, and with a slow shutter speed, it would be a brighter footage. But as I said, it's not just about brightness, because the shutter speed controls also the motion blur in the video. I start by saying that there is a rule according to which, in order to get the most natural motion blur in the video, the shutter speed should be set at double the frame rate. If we're shooting at 24 frames per second, we should set it at 1/48th of a second, but that doesn't exist on these cameras. So we set it at 1/50th of a second. That's close enough and it works. Like that, we get the most natural motion blur. What happens if we set it slower? If we set it slower, we get more motion blur and the video would look unnatural. But sometimes it's used in scenes where, I don't know, where there is a dream, like one of the characters is having a dream, or the protagonist is remembering something, and that may work, may give the idea of a dreamy situation, like a dreamy look. If we set it faster than double of the frame rate, we lose the motion blur and the video would look like unnatural, weird. It's a particular look. Sometimes they use it in cinema, like in war movies, for example, Saving Private Ryan, or horror movies when a character is about to murder someone or there's a psychopath or something like that. But again, if you want to get the most natural motion blur, you just have to set the shutter speed double the frame rate. Aperture controls directly the amount of light passing through the lens and hitting the sensor. You can control it through the lens, through its aperture blades. If you close them, you will get less light in the video. If you open them, it will be much more light. The aperture is measured in f-stops. The higher the number, the narrower the aperture. The lower the number, the wider the aperture. There are different lenses and they all have different apertures. The ones that allow you to open wider than the others, they're called fast lenses. A fast lens can open up to f1.8, 1.4, or even 1.2, which is very wide. And that's very good in low light conditions. So you can open the lens wide open and get usable footage even in very low light conditions, like the Nifty 50 is f1.8. It works fine in low light conditions. But also the aperture is not just about the light, because it controls also the depth of field. What's the depth of field? Is the thickness, the amount of space that will be in focus beyond and before the subject. If you set a narrow aperture when you focus on the subject, also everything else in the background will be in focus. A narrow aperture can be f8, f16, f22. The more you close the aperture, the more there will be stuff in focus in the background. You want everything beyond the subject and in the background and before the subject in the foreground to be out of focus so that you isolate the subject. You need a wide aperture, like f1.8, f1.4, and so on, even f1.2. The last thing is the ISO. What is it when you don't have enough light? Let's say, for example, when I go shooting and it's a low light situation and I'm shooting 24 frames per second, the shutter speed, since I want a natural motion blur, is 1/50th of a second, and I set the aperture as wide as my lens allows me to. So let's say if I shoot with the 24 millimeters, it's gonna be 2.8. If I shoot with the Nifty 50, it's gonna be f1.8. But let's say if the light is still not enough, I use the artificial way of brightening the footage, which is the ISO. The basic ISO is 100. Sometimes I need just a couple hundreds, like let's say I need to set it just to ISO 200, ISO 400 to get the correct exposure. Sometimes it's more difficult, it's very dark, so I need to set it to 800, 1000, or even sometimes at 1600, 3200, and so on. But I wouldn't recommend shooting at higher ISOs, because when you do so, your footage is very likely to get digital noise. What's digital noise? It's grain, like colored dots shining all over your footage, and it's very difficult to get rid of them in post, if not impossible sometimes. So try to set your ISO at the lowest possible number, like ISO 100, 200, 600. Try not to go over 1600, for example. Like with the M50, I would never go over 1600. With the 90D, sometimes I shot at 3200 and I got usable footage, but I like to keep it lower. I want to make sure I get usable footage all the time. So this is how more or less ISO works. I hope you understood, and also you understood how they work together, because you cannot play around much with the shutter speed and the aperture for what concerns light. Like in low light conditions, if you don't want to change the motion blur in your footage, you can compensate with the ISO. Anyway, what about the opposite situation when you have way too much light? Well, when I shoot outdoors, for example, and there's so much light in the sun, I shoot at 24 frames per second, shutter speed 1/50th of a second. If I'm vlogging, I don't mind closing the aperture, because that's a way of darkening the footage and to expose it correctly. So I can set the aperture to f8, f12, f16, something like that, and everything will be in focus. And since I'm vlogging, I don't mind, it's all right. But if I want a shallow depth of field, I really want to keep a wide aperture. Otherwise, I lose the shallow depth of field. I can't change the shutter speed because I need that motion blur. I don't need a different. I don't need more, I don't need less. But everything's overexposed. What do I do? Well, then that's when I need something that will help me to expose the footage correctly. ND filters. What are they? Well, neutral density filters. They act kind of like sunglasses for your lens. There are many different ones, all with different intensity. For example, ND2, ND4, ND8, and so on. The higher the number of the ND filter, the more it will help you to darken the footage. It will block a little bit of the light, so you don't have to change your shutter speed or aperture. And that's how you can get the footage the way you want, with that natural motion blur and that buttery awesome shallow depth of field. So this was my first video about camera basics. I hope I was clear, I hope you understood. If not, you can just rewind and watch again. And I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, smash the like button, subscribe if you aren't already, and I will see you guys in the next video.